Alright, so since the guy totally rage quit on me, I'm gonna make a video response. Is the Mellophone a tuba? I don't know, does money grow on trees? No, obviously this is not a tuba. This is not an expanded bore instrument. I don't even know what the hell a tuba would be, since there's so many tubas and all of them are drastically different and don't sound the same. Let's look at this one more time. 460 bore, not very big. Somewhere around 24 to 30 inches of cylindrical tubing on this thing. That is a lot. Alright, so, is this really an alto flugelhorn? I don't know. You tell me. These bells almost line up. No, that's not an alto flugelhorn. It ain't even freaking close. It doesn't sound the same. It doesn't play the same. This has basically 0 inches of cylindrical tubing. I've actually looked down this lead pipe. It is conical the whole way. Tapered. Entire lead pipe. Seriously. The only cylindrical portion of this horn is through the valves. So, somewhere around 50%? Zero. Almost the same size, bell? Okay. Let's say I chopped this off and I made the bell the same size. Then, if I make the argument that, okay, that's fine, that makes this an alto flugelhorn, right? Well, now it's definitely not a tuba, because we've added a foot and a half of tubing and gotten not an inch bigger. So what the heck would a tuba look like if it were that same bore profile? Here's a cornet. Boy, this should look a little bit familiar, huh? By the way, you guys that say that these things are conical, you two are also on crack. Because, I don't know if you've ever thought about it, but this to here is shorter than what's on a trumpet. So, we've got this on our head, right? Now let me introduce to you another instrument, and let's ask if it's a cornet. The Kanstul 14C Marching Alto Horn. Now, you know what, I'm gonna be honest with you. This isn't a very big alto horn, not by any stretch. It's bigger than an altonium. It's bigger than all those marching alto horns that were super small so that they could try to get away with the French horn mouthpiece. This won't play with French horn mouthpiece at all. It doesn't play very well with a trumpet mouthpiece, and in fact, that's kind of the problem with these things. They sound pretty good, they're stupid loud. Intonation is questionable, but that's okay. A good player can get around it. Problem is, can you get a good player to play one of these? Not really. Not with the big 18.5mm mouthpiece this thing takes. Now, I don't have that mouthpiece here right now because it's off being copied. But it's, you know, 18.5mm V-cup. Pretty nice. Shallow, French horn looking mouthpiece. Wide rim. Very comfortable to play if, you know, you don't mind playing that kind of thing. Guess how many inches of cylindrical tubing are on the marching alto horn? What do you think? 30? 20? How about 18? 18 inches, less than 2 feet. Less than a third of this instrument is cylindrical. Is this a cornet? No. Obviously not a freaking cornet. How could it be? It doesn't play like a cornet. It doesn't sound like a cornet. It doesn't look like a cornet. Like, holy shit. If I wrapped this like a cornet, it would look so wildly different. So again, let's compare. Which one of these is closer to a tuba? Do you think it's this guy or the one that's bigger? I know you're thinking. Is the alto horn actually bigger than the marching mellophone? Because I mean, boy, you put them side by side and it looks close. Except we've got the tilted bell again to worry about. So this comes down here. And oh, yes, indeed. Yes, indeed. Ah, yeah. Doesn't stand a chance. This has way more air volume, and it shows when you play it. This is a hell of a lot closer to a tuba than this ever wishes it could be. But is this even an alto tuba? No, it's not. No, it's a sax horn. Plays like a sax horn. It's got that out-of-tune middle G, like all of them do. There were alto horns that were way bigger than this. You know, hop on eBay, look for like really old rotary alto horns. Those things were huge. You know, there's your alto tuba. Or the old cons with 500 bore, that's probably what you want. Now, problem is, do you really need that? No. Why are you gonna use an E-flat alto horn? Like, for what? You know, to get soprano alto tenor bass, use a baritone horn. Play really high on a baritone horn. It sounds exactly the same. Well, it sounds better, actually. And the intonation will be better. I mean, you don't need all of your instruments to be in different keys to get soprano, alto, tenor, bass. And in fact, I'm going to prove that in the future. I have to get something with four vowels, but I do have an alto to show off. We're not there yet. So, this is not a cornet. This isn't a cornet either. It's not a sax horn, it's not a flugelhorn, and it's not a tuba. What is it? Closest this thing is to a trombone. It's obviously not that either, but that's as close as you're gonna get. Next thing, mouthpieces. People want to talk about this horn uses this mouthpiece, this horn uses this, so that's the... Stop it, okay? I don't have this mouthpiece here to show you, but you can use a cup mouthpiece on this. You can use a V-cup. I think the Bach Alto mouthpieces are cup-shaped. This came with a V. Yeah, that nice funnel, you blow into that thing, blow your guts into it. Stupid loud, sounds great. I've never played this with a, you know, cup type mouthpiece. I don't know how that would make it different. These things, I don't know how the hell you would ever say what kind of mouthpiece it uses. Again, you know, you can use anything on this, pretty much. Anything between like probably 19 and 16 millimeter with all levels of cup volume, it will make a sound and probably be somewhere in tune. Probably the only thing it doesn't play that great with is a French horn mouthpiece, and you can get mouthpieces for that even. They've worked on that. I've got a flugelhorn mouthpiece in here, and it's a nice deep V-cup. But I have another flugelhorn mouthpiece that I use on the other mellophone, the Bach 5A, and you know what? It's not a V-cup. It's a deep round cup. Trying to determine what instruments are based on their mouthpiece is stupid. It doesn't work. You know, like cup shape? No. Cup shape affects the sound, but it doesn't do anything else. Like, it's not a determining factor. So let's compare these two. Just in case you forgot how much difference there was in a cornet and a flugelhorn, there's a lot. Heck, we'll flip them around just so you can see really well. So now we need to ask one final question. Is this soprano tuba? No, it's not. Too small of a bore, too small a profile. There's a hell of a lot in between cornet and tuba, okay? It's called a sax horn. Now, the modern flugelhorn is kind of a soprano horn, kind of. There used to be really big flugelhorns, and then there's the soprano sax horn. You can't really get the big flugelhorns anymore because, you know what, they played like trash. Seriously, they're gone, because people hate playing instruments that play like trash. I mean, this doesn't play that good to begin with. You want something that plays worse. So we've got a much smaller instrument than what would be a tuba. Well, it's as close as you're going to get. That's fine. And you're not going to get anything better or closer because there is really not much out there that's bigger than a flugelhorn. There might be a few, like there's large bore flugelhorns, and that's going to get you a little bit closer. That's the best you can do, though. This is like a medium bore flugelhorn. It's, European for playing outside. Doesn't sound as good, but that's alright. There's a lot of things people keep trying to say are cornets that are not cornets. One of the distinguishing features of a cornet is that it doesn't have first partial because it's too cylindrical. It's not conical. This is not a conical instrument. Stop saying it is. Yeah, it's more conical than a trumpet, barely. By basically this here. Is that really what you're going by? Like 3 inches? Is that what floats your boat? Let me show you one more instrument that needs to be added to this rant.
Let me go get it.
Because this is the one that everyone always gets wrong. The baritone horn. By the way, no, this is not the same as a tenor horn. The baritone horn. Again, not a cornet. The only truly cylindrical tubing on this instrument is this. I haven't measured that, but it's not a hell of a lot, is it? Now, granted, if you don't want to rag on this bit here for taking its sweet time to get to here, okay, fine. It's more cylindrical than a euphonium. It's also about half the size. People will say, what's the difference between a baritone horn and a euphonium? I don't know, open your eyeballs. Now, do you notice anything? Looks a little more like it, doesn't it? That's because this is a sax horn, and this is a sax horn, and this is a sax horn. Use your eyeballs, use the numbers you got in front of you. Don't go by stupid stuff like how instruments get used in a type of band. That's not a very good idea. Don't go by mouthpiece shape. That's stupid. Don't go by things that don't make sense. If you can set the instrument out in front of you and very clearly see that, holy shit, these two things look about the same. Maybe they're about the same. And maybe this isn't. Just maybe. Just saying. No, I'm not going to tell you. Have a nice day.